Tables have been pretty important in my life. Though I don't remember it so, I'm certain that as an infant I was often changed on the table. The table. Set the table. Whose turn is it to set the table? Is there company coming? Should we use the regular plates or grandma's fine china? Set extra plates at the table. We had a kitchen table with a leaf that fit in the middle to enlarge the surface and make room for invited guests. We ate at the table. We laughed at the table, studied at the table, cried at the table. The table with a blanket over it magically became a fort. Big events changed the look of the table. Gourds at Halloween, a cornucopia at Thanksgiving, pine cones and tinsel for Christmas, maybe a creche, painted eggs at Easter. Sometimes being summoned to the table was a chore. Countless times I wanted to play, and hearing my name called loudly meant supper time, dinner time. With two parents and four kids, it could get pretty cacophonous at the table. Of course, we all took turns setting and clearing the table. In later years, my mother would hand sew my clown costumes at her table. My mother and I had a conversation a while ago which blew my mind. She'd been reading a book with her church group about a place at the table, and her assertion was that no matter how we felt about a certain individual in the White House, we would still be obligated as Christians to offer him a seat at our table. Really, Mom? I don't know if I'm such a good Christian that I could get past my disgust with this man enough to share a table with him. I'm sure I'd have a very difficult time being civil with my tongue. As in my childhood, I'd probably wolf down my food and ask to be excused early. But she's right. If there was food to be shared, the offer would have to be made. My mother's table is where she handled all her voluminous correspondence until last week. Last week, my mother took a very bad fall and ended up on her kitchen floor in a puddle of blood. She didn't even remember feeling faint, just woke up on the floor. Luckily, she has one of those emergency alert buttons, and EMTs arrived and got her to the hospital. Unfortunately, due to COVID-19, none of my three siblings can visit her, nor any of her friends. Fortuitously, my older brother David and his wife Ruth have just this year moved back to Vermont, and they have a bedroom all ready for her when she finishes rehabilitation. Now my brother's table will become my mother's table. It has a very circle of life feeling to it. Sadly, she'll be losing some of her independence, yet happily, there is a safe and comfortable place for her and her cat Sophie. I guess I can be happy that the next time we all see each other will be at a table I've never even seen before, a table ready to house its own dinners and puzzles and memories. Also, I wanted to take a moment to thank the congregation for all the prayers and candles you've lighted for her. Blessings.